Hi, I'm Joe Keeslar. I want to show you a little bit about our technique for putting in wire, but first we want to look at some of the basic tools that are needed to make this happen. In doing the wire work, you need some way of hanging on or holding the piece that you're going to be working on, whether it be a knife handle, a sheath, whatever it might be. And a shop-made piece that you can make for very little money is a bowling ball vise, and it's made from a bowling ball, as you can well see. It has a base plate on the top here that's about a quarter inch plate with a drill press vise that's mounted to that. And then that all sets into nothing more than a mowing machine, yard mowing machine wheel, and that allows you to have a way of holding onto your project. Some of the other basic tools that we use in doing the wire work are little chisels. This is one that I use here. Mr. Bill Moran and Jay Henriksen came up with a design. It's very well. It's made from basically an X-Acto handle and blade. It's been reground, and then the handle itself is nothing more than an engraver's handle, and they're put together so that you can grip it. I use about three of these in my inlay work. The only difference between the three is actually the width of the tool itself to accommodate putting the wire into small radiuses and curvatures. Other than that, the tools are the same. Other tool that I use, I call it a push stick, and it's nothing more than something that looks similar to the chisel, but it's blunt on the end, kind of like a very small screwdriver, and this is used for justifying the line or straightening out the wire once it's partially inletted into the wood. Other tools that come in handy, of course, are something to draw with. This is a drawing pencil, maybe a pair of tweezers come in handy for little pieces that you may be working with later on. Some way of cutting the wire, and these are little wire cutters you get from a jewelry supply store. This is nothing more than a pair of little needle nose, round nose pliers, which help shape the wire and scroll shape as you're getting ready to inlet it. And of course some kind of hammer to tap the wire down into the wood itself once you've made the groove for it. For some of us who are a little older and our eyesight is not as good as it could be, maybe an optovisor comes in very, very handy so you can see the image much larger and keep the detail to play. And of course, last but not least is the actual wire that you're going to put in itself. And the wire I use is sterling silver. You could use brass, you could use copper, you could use any other kind of wire that you want. My wire comes, or I order it 8 thousandths thick by 55 thousandths wide. And this can vary depending upon the design that you're working on and so on. So this is the choice of the individual who's doing the wire work. One other little tool that comes in real handy is in my shop is a small drill that I use for putting in little pins and so on. And this is part of the process that I use in doing that. And basically that's the tools that are necessary to make this all happen.